What's up, guys? My name is Cody. Today we're going to be taking a look at some Madden NFL 16 online head-to-head mutt gameplay. And what I want to do today is I want to kind of show you my process. Right now I'm kind of working on this bunch offense. I'm kind of labbing it up, trying to show you some things. Today we're going to be focusing on PA post. That's one of my main power plays, if you will. And what I like to do with plays like PA post, which is like base plays or plays that are like going to have a lot of run in your offense. What I like to do is I like to run them a lot in online head-to-head matches. So I'll run it several times today. You'll see it. You'll see it probably for the majority of the game, actually. And but the reason I do that is because what it does is allows me to see, you know, how people are going to adjust to it, how people are going to defend it, all of those things. And so I'm really excited about it. I think you guys will learn a lot from today. I'm actually trying out a new running back. I was messing around with Darren Sproles, the throwback Darren Sproles, and one of the things I noticed is that Darren Sproles does not have the greatest. And there's Calvin Johnson for you guys. That's why you get him as a user, because he can just jump up and pick stuff that most people won't be able to touch. He just gets really good animations. But anyway, I was messing around with the throwback Darren Sproles, and one of the things I was noticing was because I run a pass heavy scheme, when my running back goes out for a route, I need catching traffic. In my opinion, catching traffic is one of the most important and underrated statistics that you'll be able to find. The better the catching traffic and route running, the better. And Marshall Faulk, I'm using the standard legend version. He has 88 route running and 90 catching traffic, which is like one of the best out of all the running backs. So I'm just kind of looking to see how he's going to do today. But there you can see. And there you see that catching traffic coming into play right there, right at the beginning of the game. So that's why I'm using him. I still got the Sproles on the roster today, and he may get a couple of takes out here, but yeah, that's what I've got going. So in situations like this, what I like to do, so right here we're second down, probably gonna go cover two. Yep, goes cover two, and I like to block the running back. I don't always do this. Normally I'm kind of the kind of guy that really likes to put everybody out on a route. I don't really like to block extra guys if I can help it. But right there, I mean, clearly you can see he was stacking the pressure up in the middle of the field, and I was able to get it. One of the cool parts about running this, and it's a play-action play, is that you get some different responses than you would normally if it was just a standard play. And so we were able to get better blocking and deliver the ball for a touchdown. Ah, crap. It was a little early on the throw. But starting out pretty good. So, yeah. The defense is the same as always. I'm running New England this year. If you guys want to check out that defense, you can get that in the description. But basically, been running it most of the year. And the cool part about running something, you know, for so long is you get so comfortable in it that it's second nature. You know, how to stop certain things becomes second nature. And you can actually really perform well. I've always valued edge pressure over gap pressure, always, and this year is no different. Even though, you know, the hot pressure is gap blitzes and things like that, I'm just way more into the edge pressure because I think the edge pressure does more for your team as a whole, and so that's why we run it. Kind of a little finicky on my setups here, and he ends up dotting me over the middle of the post route. But yeah, and you'll see, you know, you'll think you'll know what I'm doing, and then I'll do something, and you'll have no clue where it came from, because it's just like I can adjust so fast out of this defense because I've ran it for so long. Here we get aggressive, but we get the knockdown. The thing about corners, I talked about this a little bit in my ratings commentary, which is one of my more recent videos. So if you didn't see that, go ahead and check that out. But yeah, the ratings, I really just value corners that have high coverage and high speed. So, and high coverage, so zone coverage is what I run. So that's what I look for. If you have high zone and high speed, You can play on my squad. Wondering where we're gonna. There's the inside zone. And you see what happened right there. This is, and I said this before, but I don't think I ended up getting the video. The video kind of screwed up, so I had to re-record. When you, early on in the game, you see that happen to me a lot. If you guys have watched me play, you'll see that a lot of times when people run inside zone against me, my linemen just kind of fall down. Well, it's because I'm dropping my linemen in coverage. If you want to defend the inside zone better, just stop dropping your linemen in coverage, and they won't fall down. I don't know if that helps anyone, but that's what I've been doing, and just that little adjustment right there has really helped me out. I thought I put got lucky there. I thought I put my corner in a deep blue, but he didn't seem like he agreed with me. Verticals. Kason just got roasted. I gotta look. Gosh dang it. I wish they showed like replays where it can show where we got beat. Let me see what happened. Okay, so here you can see. So all my guys are yellow. What happened was they were tired and they'd been on the field, and eventually we just ran out of gas. It's really pretty much all that happened there, because Kason just couldn't keep up with Crabtree on that. It really had nothing to do with the play call. The play call will work nine times out of ten, but unfortunately he, you know, whatever reason, he didn't play it well. I'm not returning any more kicks this year. I've had terrible luck with fumbles. I don't think that it has anything to do with your carry rating anymore. I've just fumbled the ball so many times. And, like, I have players that have good carry rating. Like, that's not the issue. It just literally is my team fumbles the ball. And that's pretty much how it goes. So I'm trying to stay away from the taking it out of the end zone, even though I'm feel, because I just really like to return kicks. You know, I just like to try to get, you know, kick returns. All right, so right here you can obviously tell. I mean, he's probably setting something up to the left side. So we're gonna try to hit Hines Ward, and nothing there. Go high pass lead. Boyd goes up and mosses him. One of the things I think it's important to realize is that this game is a game of leverage, and I'll be talking about that a little bit more in a future video. But basically what I mean by leverage is you want to, your player has position, and you want to, what you're really looking at getting is position. It's not about this play beats zone, this play beats man, it's not about that at all. It's your leverage. So for example, here I have inside leverage. You see me running this setup. I've ran this setup most of the game is because I have inside leverage, because the corner on the far left is outside of my receiver. And what it means is I have inside leverage, which means I can easily throw these inside breaking patterns and it's going to be wide open. There's nothing he can do about it because I just have the leverage advantage. What he'll have to do is he'll have to move his corner inside. When he does that, then I'll throw to the outside with Hines Ward on a out route instead of a slant. But that's pretty much the basic concept that we're going to be working here. And I threw it to the wrong guy. I did, because I high pass leaded it, or high pass led it, and I was trying to throw to the deep post route, breaking over the middle, because it was wide open. So see here, so this is a perfect example. So see now he brings these corners down. So now I have a quick read to Hines Ward in the flat, and I've actually started to throw that flat route more. I really never threw the flat route before, but I'm really getting more into the leverage discussion, and I really do. I think it matters a lot for how you read that play. That flat route, I remember in Madden, I think it was 12, when I first started running the PA post play out of the bunch. I did a full video breakdown of it, I think. So I first started running that play. Dang it, I'm really struggling with that route. But I first started running this play in Madden 12, and I would throw that flat route against man-to-man, because during Madden 12, it created a natural pick and rub. And here, this year, I mean, it's starting to kind of dwindle. It's not quite doing it as well. So you start slanting the guy over the middle because the slant is okay at beating man. But I started running Z-spot a lot too this year. And the thing was, gosh dang it, Calvin, got lucky. I think he's running Tyrod Taylor. That's why he's missing all these throws. Anyways, I started running Z spot more, and I was realizing that the flat is really, really effective, especially in this year's game, much like it used to be in like Madden 12-ish. But so I started throwing that little flat route, and it's really paid off for me. It's just a couple quick hits a game. It's nothing too special, but I'm telling you guys, I mean, it really has made a big difference in my game. So I'm gonna keep throwing it. Crap! I forgot to put Ilka in a hook. Sometimes you get a little ahead of yourself on defense, and you'll see that's kind of my MO. Is I do that a lot. Is I'll get ahead of myself defensively. There's PA wide receiver in. Pick. Come on. Are you serious? That's hilarious. I tell you what, man, I've had some really screwy things happen to me today. But see, here now is where you can start dropping guys off the line of scrimmage because it's 2nd and 12. You know, he's probably not going to run it on 2nd and 12. And then you can start dropping guys off. Once I can start dropping guys off of the line of scrimmage, then I get really, really good with my coverages because then I can start containing and doing all the things that I wanted to do anyway. So here it is. There's one-man pressure, guys. One-man pressure. If you want good pressure, there is, I don't know. I mean, that's the best pressure I've ever made. I mean, one-man pressure is freaking good, man. And I'll put it up against any offense. One-man pressure, you have a spy on the field. I don't know. It's just a really, really good play. Ilka got burned. That's the problem with it is when they... That is the one problem with this defense, in my opinion, is when we go man-to-man, if the pressure doesn't come in, then I'm kind of in trouble. As you saw right there, pressure didn't come in. I think he blocked a running back or something. And it gave him a lot more time in the pocket than he should have had. All right, so now I have, real quick, I have inside leverage, so I'm going to leave Hines Ward on an inside breaking pattern. Check it down to Baldwin. We got good late read to Baldwin. And we're going to take it down, try and score real quick. Reason you want to try to score real quick is because you want to give him the ball so that he can give you the ball back. That's the idea here. I mean, we've seen how his offense is running. He's not very efficient. Got a quick little snap throw in the end zone. Minute and a half. We got 3 timeouts, so we're looking really, really good right now. But anyway, one of the things, too, to remember, too, when you're doing this, I mean, this is a lab game. I'm not trying to win $100,000 here, so you know you're going to see me run PA post almost every single play. And the reason is because I want to show you guys kind of how I go about developing it, how I go about fine-tuning it. I've ran PA post every single play or a large majority of my plays for about 3 games, and you're starting to kind of see it come together and start to look really, really good. And then this play right here, dang it, I don't know why. The one time I throw it really good, Nelson drops it. But yeah. This is how I get really, really good at my plays, is repetition. And like I said, I lean heavily on a quote from Tom Moore. Basically, talks about NFL teams try to do too much, keep it simple, and play fast is kind of their philosophy. And Tom Moore was Peyton Manning's offensive coordinator, kind of built the offense that made Peyton Manning the quarterback he is. Obviously, the offense isn't the only thing that made Peyton Manning the quarterback that he is, but it did play a role in it. And I just, you know, I think the philosophy behind it is really, really good. And so I try to apply that to Madden. So he throws a screen there. I should have dropped my guys off because he's not going to run the ball now. There's a screen. Should have guys out there. Dang it. One thing you got to learn when you're playing this game is you got to be kind of hesitant on how you see he's going to send So like right here, right? He's probably going to run the screen to the left side. So watch. Nope, those verticals. Pick. Oh, come on, Calvin. So if he throws a screen, I'm going to pick. Catch that inbounds. Dang it. Well, a little slip screen, huh? A little slip screen. Crap, I didn't get everything off. Pick. Oh my gosh, Aaron Lynch. We're in a Z spot. That's the next play I'm going to discuss, is Z spot. I'm going to talk a lot about that play. That play is probably, I mean, it's a really powerful freaking play. And you can talk for hours on it. I was listening to something. I can't even remember what it was. It was a coaching podcast or coaching something. Oh, great play by Lamonte David. Give me a block. Oh, shoot. But it was some kind of coaching podcast or something. But it was it was a football life about Vince Lombardi. So the NFL series. And I was watching it. And anyway, what they were saying, they were talking about Lombardi and the Packer sweep. And they said that Lombardi, when he taught, he was at a coaching conference one time, he spent, and this is, again, in one play, he spent five hours talking about this Packer sweep. Okay? And why it was important that they develop and they learn everything they can about this Packer sweep. Now, I take that same philosophy to Madden. Okay? I love Coach Lombardi. I think he's dead accurate with what he's trying to do here. And I take that same exact mentality to Madden, is that what we're going to do, what we're going to be about, is we're going to be about executing. And I think everything in life, not just Madden or football or whatever, everything in life is about depth. Can you be deep? Can you be deep enough in your knowledge of things? And so that's what I constantly strive for, is depth, and Madden is no different. Dang it, Marshawn, you couldn't get on the ground. Give me one more play. But yeah, so that's what we do. So what we're doing right now, this is our attempt at emulating Lombardi and the Packer sweep. We want to learn everything we can about this PA post, because this is one of our main plays that we're going to utilize, especially against like inside, when we have inside leverage, because this play is set up for you to have inside leverage. If you look at it real quick, let me pull it up on the play art here. It's an inside leverage play, right? You've got two routes, two powerful routes that are breaking over the middle. And so it's built for leverage and the kind of leverage that we want to work with here. So it's a really good little play. And there's so many ways to run it, but what we want to do is we want to get our reads down. And we want to get not only our reads down, but we want to figure out, okay, where are we weak against? What do we need to watch out for? So, like, for example, right here, he's probably in cover two. And it's probably one of the better defenses to go against this with. But what it leaves open is this route to Baldwin over the middle if they don't use or control it. So, again, but it's knowing what they're in. So and that's what you want to practice. So here, cover three, could be sending heavy pressure blitz off that left edge. We got Hines Ward on the flat, nothing there. And we got Boyd over the middle, ends up dropping it. It's our first incompletion. But yeah, I mean, and this is what we do. I mean, this is how I do it. And this is how I would recommend it. This is how I would recommend you learning how to do anything, especially in Madden. It's all about repetition. It really is, guys. It really is. So here, and that's something I've learned over. I've thrown my share of interceptions with that post route, and I know exactly how I need to click on it. I know exactly how I need to catch it. It's repetition, guys. I'm telling you. It's all about repetition. Here he leaves it open. I should have thrown a freaking high pass lead. I didn't throw the high pass lead. He ended up being able to recover. So he's going to try to, what he's going to start doing is he's going to try to start baiting me into throwing that route, because he's seen it so many times. He's starting to get really frustrated with it. And what you'll see here is a little adjustment by me now, a little chess game. is we're going to swing Sproles out in the backfield. Watch. Oh, dang it. He ended up going with Hines Ward. But yeah, now we're playing chess. We're playing a little cat and mouse game, and this is what we want to do. You know, this is what we want to do, because now he's got to overplay it. Now, if we were running the rest of our offense, this would give us, you know, so many opportunities to run other things that we wanted to have in the game plan. But anyhow. And there's a touchdown. John Brown. Oh, he dropped it. Oh, my gosh. John Brown. We were 16-16, and we just threw four straight incompletions. That is so freaking frustrating, because he had a touchdown, and he just drops it. Oh, it's okay. All right, so... throw it up. Yeah, that's okay. That's okay. I mean, we could throw an interception. I mean, it's fourth down. We were just trying to throw it. We had to get it past first down. Pressure was coming in on us. He played it well. We could have checked it down easily to the drag, but it wouldn't have given us the yards we needed. So we just threw it up. But that's okay. So it'll be interesting to see what he does now. And there's a little post right over the middle. Part of defense, too, and this is something I continually have to learn the hard way, is a lot of defense comes down to knowing your responsibilities. I don't know how that wasn't intercepted, but a lot of defense comes down to knowing your responsibilities. So on certain plays, I have one play that I'm literally allowed to do whatever the frick I want just because of the way that I designed the play. You know, I can do literally whatever I want because I have the deep coverage to be okay. And then there's other plays where I run where I have very specific assignments on defense to myself. You know, I got to cover the left curl flat or the left deep or the left streak or the left post or whatever it is. But the key too is, like, sometimes you'll see them run plays that you think you know where they're going, and so you'll get out of position. And when you get out of position, they'll hit you for like 30 or 40 yards across your face because you weren't paying attention to where they were going. And I find that's why I love over-the-top coverage. Oh, nice dot. I don't know who that was. So he puts in Tony Romo here. That's probably a good adjustment. But anyway, that's my kind of two cents on it, which is why I normally like to run plays where I can, like, just roam. But you can't always do that. Ronnie Lott, make that play. Make your money, man. Calvin, go get the ball, buddy. That's really a big point about defense is you have to know your assignment. You got to do your job. It's the Bill Belichick Patriot way. I mean, do your job. And oh, there's Calvin again. Calvin's playing himself a heck of a game. I think we got bailed out right there because of the pressure. He had me beat because I didn't do my job, but he had me beat. So anyway, let's get back into some good offensive football here. Oh my goodness, I got so lucky. Problem with play action this year is it's hard to get, I don't know. It's just, for some reason they like run back, and I don't really understand why they do it, but they do it, and it drives me insane. And it causes so many issues. A little crossing pattern to Baldwin. I wish that they had this built into the game where Ward would go on a little out and then come back in, but he won't do that, unfortunately. All right, so I need to go. Third and four. Oh my goodness, I don't know how Osweiler did not put the ball where I wanted it to go. And so you see, that's the thing. Like, as good as we looked, I mean, we were like 16 for 16 or something like that. And now we're not looking so hot, you know. And that's just part of the deal. And we get mossed over the top, and he's right back in the game. That's Joe Horn out there. I'm telling you, man, you just get Moss because I have the advantage in zone coverage. I have the advantage in speed. I have the advantage in every category. But sometimes you just get Moss. I'm telling you, it does have something to do with the ratings because it lessens your chance. But you're still gonna get Mossed. It's still gonna happen. But anyway, oh my gosh, Josh Brown, get out of the end zone. You've already dropped a touchdown for me. But yeah, and again, the thing about labbing is, and the cool part, and this is why it's so important to do it, is you need to throw your interceptions. You need to fail. You need to fail so you can succeed. It's the whole Michael Jordan, I failed over and over and over again, and that's exactly why I'm able to succeed. Oh, see, and that's good user. See, that shows you right there what they're going to start doing to stop you. And, you know, I mean, that was just a really good play by him because he had me. And he baited me and I threw it. That was a really good play by him right there. That was a good play by me, but I just didn't get the pick. Knew where he was going with the ball. But I think this way of playing makes you better because, again, it just shows you all your weak spots. It shows you where your play is not as good as you think it is. I thought that should have been a pick. Case on against Robert Woods one-on-one, and Robert Woods freaking teleports through him. Come on, man. But, yeah, I mean, again, and this is all good because what this is doing is it teaches me. Now again, I'm not trying to make excuses for myself for making bad throws. I mean, those were bad reads. Those were bad reads on my part. And what you'll come to find is that almost every interception you throw, there's somebody open. The reason you throw the interception is because you either focus too much on one receiver, which is what I did right there, or you don't look before you throw. And I do that a lot as well. So yeah. No crossing pattern underneath. Cause he's still usering. He's still usering that deep post route. What you'll see is I'll make an adjustment at some point here. I'm already playing in the adjustment. But basically what we're gonna try to do is hit him in behind there. Nice throw by Osweiler under pressure. And see, again, all I have to do is just send a streak up that seam and I'll be fine. But so watch this here. Throw it away. Freaking put the wrong hot routes out there. So this verticals play here, I mean, this is where you make your money if they start overplaying you. And there's Josh Brown, or John Brown, hitting him deep. But again, we tried to just run the one play. But I mean, he has it locked, so we have to go to something else. And now we're back. See what I'm saying? So, I mean, all you have to do is do that once. Just kind of get, you know, make him honest. Because again, I mean, if you're going to run the same play over and over again, they're just going to sit on whatever it is you're going to do. Which is not what we're trying to see. What we're trying to get him to do is we're trying to get him to defend it, still respecting everything else we can do from this. Oh, dang it. I don't know what happened there by Osweiler, but he did not make a good throw. But when the chips are down, we have to run this play. We have to focus on developing it. Baldwin, hold on to the ball. Third and seven here. It's a big third down here. He's going to go cover two, clearly. What I'll probably do. See, I've got time. I'll probably do something like this. There it is. And there's the out route. And like I said, that's why you mix and match that out route with your leverage right there. I knew he was going some kind of cover two type deal. I knew I was going to have the leverage because he was going to be overplaying the crossing patterns because I've been running it all game long. And we were able to get the touchdown. Hit that. Nice catch. Oh, I put him out. Dang it. So right here, I play very aggressive on defense in these situations. Because if he's going to score, I want him to score fast. Like, I don't want this to be a... I'm going to try to get a turnover. I play super, super, super aggressive here. But that's me. Not everybody plays like that. But I do. There he goes underneath. He should be starting to move a little bit. There's a bunch of quads, verticals. There's a sack. I should not have called that timeout. So I got Sam Mike. So right here, I just try to send everybody. Because you know he's going to throw it. There's Shaq Thompson for the game. That's a pretty good defense right there. I mean, and that's why I play aggressive, because you get that knockout punch, and it does so much for you. Anyway, so like right here, right? So I just have the leverage advantage. And see, there's that play action. I think it does something with the zone. It softens up the zone, I know that. But anyway, that's a little something you pick up after playing a game for as long as I have. We get the one-on-one. Hit Baldwin. That's what I'm saying, catching traffic, right? I mean, I know. I mean, I've played so many games. I know how many people are going to drop that, and it comes down to catching traffic. When route running is nice and it's all fun and game, you know, it's all fun and well. But I'm telling you guys, let's throw that away. I'm telling you guys that catching traffic. It's so, so, so important. I know, and I'm just going to leave it at that. I'm just going to leave it at that because, I mean, that should tell you all that you need to know. We'll take our sack, that's okay. See, he's running man coverage down in, like, the 20-yard line, especially against PA Post. Is really good. I have this play here, this divide play, which beats man to the outside. So I'm not worried about that too much. What I want to see is what he does right here. He goes man. He does go man. We get Hines Ward one-on-one on a slant, and there's a big touchdown to close the game out. I think he's going to go ahead and quit. So, guys, thanks for watching today. I appreciate it. Like I said, I just tried to kind of bring you into my mind as I lab. It's a pretty good game to watch. You see the play like at its best in the beginning, then he starts to make adjustments, and then we start to make adjustments. And I think it's just a really good thing. I know you guys may not like it when I run one play all game, but what I think it helps show you is it helps show you the process by which I create these schemes. And definitely the really good ones, the ones that last, you know, a whole season, it takes several of these games to do that. So I just wanted to give you guys that opportunity to watch that. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you learned something from